So tumeona stationary waves a couple of slides before, but we have applications that use stationary waves. Stationary waves can be formed in pipes. Stationary waves can be formed in strings. In our applications like, so in pipes usually in longitudinal waves, na kwenye string usually in transverse waves. But how do we form kwenye pipe? Pipe inaweza tukaitumia katika two ways. Tunaweza tukaifunga kwenye end moja, kwa only one end ya pipe ikawa open, au tunaweza tukaacha open at both ends. So either way. So basically tujikumbushie, how does a full wave present ikiwa kwenye stationary wave? As you can see, hii ni progressive wave ya kwanza na hii ya chini ni progressive wave nyingine, and together they form that. So basically tunajua kutoka hapa mpaka hapa ni half wave. Okay, na kutoka hapa mpaka hapo ni full wave. So we know all that ni full wave. But katikati hapa tuta tukagawa ikawa robo, hapo ni robo na hii ni robo nyingine na hii ni robo nyingine na hii ni robo nyingine. So kutoka hapo mpaka hapo robo na robo inakuwa ni half. So yeah, basically this is important. Tuona kwa nini nimeanza kwa kuintroduce full wave presentation inavyokuwa. So we start with an open pipe kuonyesha jinsi gani a stationary wave inaweza ikakaa kwenye open pipe. Hint ni kwamba you remember the meaning of antinode na node. Antinode a point of maximum displacement, na node a point where there is no displacement. Displacement is zero. So point to remember is that always katika any open end ya pipe we cannot form an antinode. We cannot form a node. Okay, we cannot form a node at any point along the end, the open end of a pipe. That means katika hii pipe tunaanza na open, tunaanza na antinode kwenye open end. So itaenda in such a way ambapo lazima iishie huku na nini, na antinode. Okay, as you can see, lazima iishie na antinode. So the same for another progressive wave. Kumbuka ina moja inaenda to right, moja inaenda kwenye left. We start with an antinode, inaenda huku chini inamalizia na antinode. So this is the simplest mode of vibration. So the simplest vibration ambapo inaweza ikaokaa kwenye pipe. So if we complicate it further, sawa, katika second mode of vibration tuki complicate more. Tumesema this is the simplest, so tuende kwenye a bit more complex mode of vibration. So tunaanza na antinode siku zote. So we want now to increase. Kumbuka hapa tuna the simplest, so we have two antinodes na one node. So we want to increase the number of nodes hapa kwenye pipe. So let us assume tunataka tuweke a node hapa na to add one more node. Okay, the simplest vibration ina one node. A more complex vibration after that ni yenye nodes mbili. We add one more node. So tulikuwa na node moja, tunaongeza node nyingine. So make it in a way, hapa mwanzo lazima kuwe na antinode. So inaenda, ita cross hiyo. It means kama tunataka kuwe na node pale, ita touch hapa, ita cross tena that point. Okay? Ili iende kumalizikia na antinode tena. Similarly to another progressive wave, itaanzia na antinode, itaenda ita cross that node, ita touch hapo, ili ije cross tena hii antinode, ili touch hapo. So we have two more nodes. Another more complex, tuna add one more node. So we have a node at that point. We have a node at that point, tuna add one more node at that point. So tunaanza na antinode, inatakiwa icross hapo kwenye node, itatouch hapo, itacross kwenye that node, itatouch huko ili cross kwenye hii node, inamaliza na antinode. So na huko tunaanzia na antinode kwenye other progressive wave, inatouch node, inatouch hapo, inagusa node, inatouch pale, inagusa node, inamalizikia huko. So we have three nodes. Hapa tulikuwa na one node. So let us first observe. Tunataka tengeneze general formula inayo guide hizi open pipes or stationary waves kwenye hizi open pipes. So if this is the length of the pipe, remember in all the cases we don't change the length of the pipe. For the same length of the pipe, kwenye simplest mode of vibration the length ni sawa sana. Kumbuka ndio maana nilianza na introduction. If we want a quarter wave, ni aka ka segment. So aka ka segment ambapo as you can see ndio aka ka segment, ndio aka ka segment, ndio aka ka segment hapa na ndio aka ka segment. So we know distance ya kutoka hapo mpaka hapo ni aka ka segment ambapo ni quarter wave. Naka ka segment ka the second part ni another quarter. So total they form half. As you can see ni quarter na hii ni quarter ambao zimegeukia opposite sides. So the length of the pipe ni sawa na 2 quarter waves. Okay, ambao if you add ni a half wave. So ni sawa na wavelength 1 divided by 2. Okay. In the second case, well, by we have the second wavelength, because our wavelength changes. Wavelength changes in each mode of vibration, as you can see. Okay, a quarter ya hapa si sawa na quarter ya hapa, kwa sababu it needs to accommodate more nodes na more antinodes hapo katikati. So for this case, tuna aka ka quarter. You remember this is a quarter, but this is usually a half, as you can see. E1 a half. Yote ni a half. So you can see hapa katikati tuna a half. Half na huku tuna another quarter. Okay? So tuna quarter plus a quarter huku inakuwa half plus this half inakuwa ni 1. So for this case length ni sana wavelength. Length sana wavelength. For the third mode of vibration, tunakuwa na hii quarter, tunakuwa na hii half, tunakuwa na another half na tunakuwa na another quarter. So this quarter huku na quarter huku inatengeneza half. Na hizi, na hii half natengeneza 1. Na hii half natengeneza 1 and a half. Okay? So, hii generally ni half na half ni 1. Na hizi quarter mbili ni nusu. So, 1 plus a half ni 1 and a half. Ambo ni 3 over 2. 3 over 2 times wavelength. So, generally kwa kutumia hizi tatu, tunaweza tukaona kwamba kumbe general equation length ni sawa sana. But remember, hii ilikuwa ni mode of vibration number 1. Hii ilikuwa ni mode of vibration number 2. Na hili kwa mode of vibration number 3. So you can see coefficient hapa ni 1. Coefficient hapa ya mode of vibration 3 ilikuwa ni 3. Okay? For both case kuna 2 na 2. Aha, kumbe basi hapa inawezekana kulikuwa na 2. Lakini kwa vile huko chini lazima kuwe na 2, basi ilikuwa na 2. So 2 na 2 zilikansi ndio maana ikabaki 1. So kumbe wavelength over 2 is common to all. Wavelength over 2. Then what changes is the coefficient n. Ambo it will change. Kama ni simplest mode of vibration 1, na kwa n is equal to 1. For simplest mode of vibration 2, n is equal to 2. For 3, n is equal to 3. Where n is 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay? So if we have the general equation, ya length ni sawa na hiyo, we know that velocity ni sawa sana wavelength times frequency. So if from this equation, we know the wavelength from here, the wavelength ni sawa sana 2L over n. So instead of wavelength, tukaweka 2L over N instead of wavelength. So napata V ni sasana 2L over N ni sasana frequency N. Okay, because we use the wavelength N. So we have the frequency N. The velocity is still of sound. Kwa maana nikasema longitudinal waves ni kundogo zinatoka kwenye pipe. So velocity ndio ni velocity ya sound. Okay? So we have V is equal to 2L frequency ya N over N, where N is 1, 2, 3, etc. So that's our general equation. Similarly for a closed pipe, tumesema always katika open end kuna kuwa na antinode. So for this case, one end is closed. Na siku zote sehemu ambapo closed kuna kuwa na antinode. Sawa ni sawa na string. Sehemu ambapo string inakuwa inafungwa kuna kuwa ni kuna nodes, I mean. Sawa? Kwenye sehemu ambapo kuna closed end ya pipe kunatakiwa kuwe na node. Sehemu ambapo kuna open end ya pipe kunatakiwa kuwe na antinode. So if that is the case, the simplest mode, as usual, tunakuwa na antinode moja. Tunakuwa na node moja, of course na antinode moja, lakini my point of concern hapa ilikuwa ni number of nodes. So, kwenye open, tunatakuwa kuwa na antinode, inatakuwa iende, lakini kwenye end ambayo iko closed, tunatakuwa imalizike na node. Node ambayo ndo hii moja hapa. Similarly, we have another one, progressive wave, ambayo zina combined form stationary wave, inatakuwa ipite na yenyewe imalizike na antinode. Na itakuwa imalizike na node. So if we want to add one more node, tulikuwa na node moja, tunataka tuongeze node nyingine hapa. So we know antinode kwenye open end itapita, ita cross hapo, ita cross hiyo node, ita touch hapo ili ije kumalizikia na another node huko. Similarly to another progressive wave, inaanza na antinode, itapita kwenye node, ita touch hapo ili ije kumalizikia na node. For number 3 the same, tuna node ya kwanza, node ya pili, tunaongeza node ya tatu. So tunakuwa na antinode kwenye open end, ina touch node, ina touch hapo, inapita kwenye node tena, ina touch huko ili ije kumalizikia na node. simu ya itu hii ina touch ant node, ina parts kwenye node, ina touch hapo inamalizikia kwenye node, ina touch hapo inakuja kumalizikia kwenye node. So generally tunaweza tukagundua hichi kitu kwamba length kwenye simplest mode of vibration ilikuwa, kumbuka this is a quarter, you remember this is a quarter, just this, okay, just this is a quarter, so we have a quarter, a quarter, so this is a quarter, so length is a sana wavelength over 4. But for this case, for this case number 2, okay, for this case number 2, we have a quarter plus this is a half, so we have robo tatu nusu na robo, okay, so we have 3 quarters nusu na robo, kwa wavelength 3 over 4. For this case tuna half, tuna another half, na tuna a quarter. So half na half ni 1, so 1 plus a quarter inakuwa ni 5 over 4 wavelength. So generally tunakuja kurealize kwamba okay, wavelength over 4 is common to all, wavelength over 4 is common to all, what changes is again is the coefficient. But this time in the simplest vibration 1 tuna 1, in the second tuna 3, in the third kuna 5, so each time inakuwa inaongezeka kwa mbili mbili, so we have 1 3 5 7 9 etc. For n inakuwa ni 1 3 5 7 9 etc etc etc, ina proceed that way. So since v is equal to wavelength times frequency, and from here wavelength is sana 4l over n, so v inakuwa sana 4l over n times frequency n, because tulitumia wavelength n. Again observe that fundamental frequency of an open pipe is twice that of a closed pipe of the same length. Okay, if we use the simplest vibration, if we use the simplest vibration, we shall see up above what does it mean by fundamental frequency. Okay, we shall see what does it mean up by fundamental frequency. Fundamental frequency means the simplest frequency, the simplest mode of vibration, ambao ni ya kwanza. As you can see hapa ni wavelength over 2, while for this one wavelength over 4. So if you take fundamental frequency of an open pipe, okay, ni sawa sana fundamental frequency of a closed pipe times 2. If you multiply na 2 hapo unapata wavelength over 4. If you multiply this by 2, 2 na cancel na 4 inabaki 2, unapata fundamental frequency ya open pipe. Also, a closed pipe of a length L over divided by 2 produces the same fundamental as an open pipe of length L. But because both odd and even harmonics are present in the note from an open pipe, it gives a richer note. Kwa sababu gani? What does this mean? It means a closed pipe of length L over 2. If we have a length L confirmed, then for a closed pipe, tukatumia half the length of pipe ya ile open pipe. So assuming kwamba this L over, this is L over 2. Okay, so produces the same fundamental as an open pipe of length L. So if we have L over 2, we have L over 2. Okay, it means L over 2 itakuwa ni sawa sana fundamental yetu huku ni wavelength over 4. So if, as you can see, 2 inaenda huku, 2 pop pop in a form wavelength over 2, and wavelength over 2 ndo sasa na fundamental frequency ya open pipe length is that. So half of length ya huku inatengeneza the same fundamental frequency as that of the open pipe, only that because both odd and even harmonics are present in the note from an open pipe. Open pipe ina both even na odd harmonics, tuna definition maana ya harmonics, lakini ndo hii hapa, as you can see, this is odd, this is even. Odd 4 is even, 5 in both odds na even harmonics, so this gives a richer note, because the more you have, the more harmonics you have, the richer the sound becomes, and sweeter the sound becomes, the greater the timbre. Shall see there the division of the timbre. Timbre is the quality of sound, so it gives a richer note. So note end correction makes the overall length to be L plus C. Here we usually ignore end correction. Wanachomaanisha ni kwamba, kwa mfano kama una e pipe sawa, ukaweka tuning fork sawa, ili kuipa sound hiyo, ili ianze ku vibrate sawa. The distance between the tuning fork na the pipe hii tunaita C. We usually ignore, lakini the overall length inakuwa ni L plus C, where C is the end collection. So for an open pipe kunatakiwa kuwe na end collection both this side na this side. Kwa huku kunakuwa na C na huku kunakuwa na C, kwa inakuwa ni L plus 2C for an open pipe. While for a closed pipe kunakuwa with only one opening, so we have L plus C is the effective length, the total length ikitaka kuwa more accurate. Okay, yeah, so where usually for experiments we find that C ni sawa sana 0.6 times radius ya pipe. Usually C is equal to 0.6 times radius of the pipe, usually kwa experiment inatuambia hivyo. So before we proceed, okay, we shall turn a case ya spring. Okay, so a spring inakuwa tied. We have this, kwa mfano kama huu ni mti na huu ni mti, tukafunga kamba hapo, then tukai pluck at the middle ili ianze kutengeneza oscillation. Sawa, ilianze kutengeneza oscillation, itakuwa namna hiyo. Sawa, lakini hii ni complex. The simplest ni kwamba kwa vile inakuwa ni kama closed pipe at both ends, closed pipe at both ends, hapa kwenye E point, kwa sababu ni kama ndo closed end, lazima ianze na node, so itaenda na lazima imalizikie na node. So this is the simplest mode of vibration. The second mode of vibration ni tunaongeza node katikati. We have a node hapo, we have a node hapo, tunaongeza a node hapo. So we have, yatakiwa ianzie kwenye node, itapita kwenye node ili malizike kwenye node. So we have, inapita kwenye node ili malizike kwenye node. And the third mode of vibration ni hapo. So we can see hapa length ni sawa sana, hii ni half na hii ni half sana wavelength. Okay, while for here length ni sawa sana, kumbuka this is wavelength 2, this is the second mode. The simplest mode ni hapa ambao ni wavelength over 2. While for this ni sawa sana, hii ni half plus hii half ni 1 plus hii half ni 1 and a half, kwa inakuwa 3 over 2 wavelength 3. So as you can see, basically hii ni kama, hii inafanana na open pipe at both ends. As you can see, the simplest was wavelength over 2, the second was wavelength, and the third was 3 over 2 wavelength. So it's just strings ni kama open pipes. So it is important to note the following. Okay, fundamental frequency is the frequency of the simplest mode of vibration, the lowest frequency that an instrument can give. That is what we call the fundamental frequency. As you can see, all what we were starting with is not any fundamental frequency. Overtones, okay, overtones is the frequencies of an instrument higher than that of fundamental frequency. Okay, any frequency after the fundamental frequency is what we call overtone. It is over the tonic or the fundamental. Okay, the simplest, it is overtone. So apart from hizi ambazo tulikuwa tunaanza nazo, whatever that was following for this case, hii kuanzia ya pili, ya tatu na kuendelea, kuanzia ya pili, ya tatu na kuendelea, kuanzia ya pili, ya tatu na kuendelea, zote zilikuwa ni overtones. Harmonic is a signal or wave whose frequency is an integral multiple of the reference or basic fundamental frequency. So harmonic is zote ni harmonic, sawa. So the integral multiple, as you can see hapa ni 1 times the fundamental, hapa ni 2 times the fundamental, 3 times the fundamental, 4 times the fundamental. So hizo zote ni harmonics, the same to here, 1 times the fundamental, 3 times the fundamental, 5 times the fundamental, sababu inaenda kwa 1, 3, 5, 7, etc. So 1 times the fundamental, 3 times the fundamental, 5 times the fundamental, zote ni harmonics. So the signal wave which is whose frequency is an integral multiple of the reference, so basic fundamental frequency. Again, when you pluck or strike the string, the harmonics that excited, okay, the harmonics that exited now is nasotoka, would be those which have an amplitude at the position where the string is plucked, and the ones that have zero amplitude at this position will be discouraged. So if you pluck the string at the middle, for example, if you pluck the string at the middle, pale ambapo ume pluck lazima kuwe na antinode. It means unapo pluck una instruct the string kwamba at this point lazima uwe na antinode. So kwa mfano tunapokuwa na string uka pluck at the center, it means lazima iende in such a way up at the center kuwe na antinode. So it excites all the harmonics ambazo zita favor kuform antinode kwenye sehemu ambayo umepluck. So the ones that have zero amplitude disposition will be discouraged. Okay, will be discouraged. So if you pluck at the middle, okay, the string will undergo the first harmonic, which is the fundamental. Okay, you pluck at the middle, as you can see, ilikuwa ni fundamental, the simplest. If you pluck at the length quarter, so if you pluck achana here at the middle, if you pluck at the quarter, itatengeneza second harmonic. Okay, kwa sababu itatengeneza hapa antinode. Okay, itatengeneza antinode kwenye all places ambapo ni quarter, itatengeneza antinode. So itatengeneza second harmonic. Na ukipluck at L over 6 itatengeneza third harmonic. Okay, it means katika point ya 1/6 of the length of the string ukipluck itatengeneza third harmonic. So that's how it goes. Nimekuambia hii mifano kwa sababu most of the time kwenye question watakwambia the string was plucked 1/4 the length of the string, find the frequency na nini. So you have to know ikipluck at 1/4 ni harmonic gani, ili utafutie specific frequency kwenye hiyo harmonic. Okay, na ukipluck at the middle itakuwa ni harmonic gani. So you know plucking at the middle ni first harmonic, so is the simplest, unatafuta fundamental. Ukipluck 1/4 ni second harmonic. So kama ni string ni first overtone. Okay, first overtone. Sababu tumesema overtone ni frequency yote above the fundamental. It means after the fundamental inayofuata ambayo ni second harmonic. Sawa, inakuwa ndo first overtone. Sio, unanielewa? Yeah, kwamba tuna fundamental frequency. Kwa mfano wa string sasa. Fundamental frequency tumesema where n is 1 2 3 4 5 etc na kuendelea. So this number 1 is the simplest, which is the fundamental frequency. Then overtones zinaanzia frequencies kuanzia 2 na kuendelea. So 2 is the first overtone. 2, n is equal to 2 is the first overtone. Lakini kumbuka all these are harmonics. So harmonic number 1 is the fundamental frequency. Harmonic number 2 is the first overtone. So unaelewa? Yeah, kwa sababu overtones zinaanzia 2 kwenda mbele. Same for one pipe closed at one end ni 1 3, 5, 7, 9. So simplest ni 1. The first overtone ni n is equal to 3. Unaelewa? Second harmonic hapa sio n is equal to 2. So you should be very careful na hivi vitu. Zero values are n ndio harmonics. Sawa? And n is equal to 1 ndio fundamental. Then whatever that starts from there above that ni overtone. So for a string and an open both ends pipes, first n is equal to 1 ni fundamental, n is equal to 2 ndio first overtone. While for pipe closed at one end, n is equal to 1 ndio fundamental, the first overtone ni n is equal to 3, kwa sababu yeye anaanza 1 nafuata 3 naenda 5 nafuata 7 etc etc. I think it's very clear. Again, we have a term called bits, which is the rise and fall of loudness of sound when two sources of sounds of nearly equal frequencies produce sound together. Ukiwa na vifaa viwili vinatengeneza zinatoa sound ya frequency almost inakaribiana karibiana, then you will notice a sudden rise and fall of sound where they cancel, there is interference, they cancel and in some place they reinforce each other. Because there's that sudden rise and fall of sound, loudness of sound when two sources of nearly equal frequencies are produced together, and then it one bit, whereby the bit frequency inakuwa simply the difference between the two. Okay, the bit frequency, kwa mfano kama moja ina 2 hertz nyingine ina 2.01 hertz because they are nearly equal frequencies, then the bit frequency ni 2 minus 2.01 kwa inakuwa ni 0, ile 0.1 that difference ndio inakuwa ni bit frequency. Again, you have echo versus reverberation. Tulivyokuwa wadogo tumekuwa tukicheza sehemu kipike kile inakujibu kwa ile mwangwi, that's what we call echo, so reflected sound. but reverberation is multiple echoes. Unapokuwa kwenye acoustic buildings, unapokuwa kwenye majengo makubwa, theaters, ukipiga kelele kwa sababu inakuwa na kuta tofauti tofauti, kunatokea na echoes nyingi nyingi. So the sound might be reflected more than once. Inagonga kwenye ukuta hii, inaenda inagonga kwenye ukuta mwingine. So the multiple reflection of sounds is what we call reverberation, the reverb. Again, just know the normal definitions of wavelength. I believe you know, it's the distance, okay, the distance traveled by the wave. That's what we call the wavelength, the distance traveled by the wave in one complete oscillation. That's what we call the wave. The amplitude is the maximum displacement of particles in a wave, while the period is the total time for one complete oscillation. And the frequency is the number of crests and troughs passing through a point per unit time. Okay, number of crests and troughs passing per unit point in a specified time. There are various definitions of frequency. I don't think I'm out of shindo to define it. Again, we have characteristic of sound. We have pitch, where is the highness or lowness of sound. That's what we call the pitch, the highness or lowness of sound. We have the timbre, which is the quality of sound. Timbre is the quality of sound. So, oh, this music is sweet, or oh, this music is very boring. So that's what we define timbre that way, the quality of the sound that we hear. Where loudness, again, is somehow like pitch. It's specifically in a quad based on intensity. Okay, this sound is very high, this sound is very low. While pitch, this sound has very high frequency, this sound has very low frequency. So pitch and loudness, they are somehow related, because you will always have a loud sound when the frequency is high, and you will always have a low sound when the frequency is low.